Now, I know many people are so eager to get outside and enjoy this lovely summer weather, but in the midst of a pandemic, we know most of you guys are also worried about summer safety. So here to answer some of your questions is Dave Nida. He's an emergency physician and clinical instructor at the University Hospitals in Denver. Dave, thank you so much for joining me today.
You bet.
I know so many people love going outside for outdoor gatherings or maybe a picnic, especially with the great weather that, you know, so many people are experiencing right now. But what is a way that you can do that with friends and family that you haven't seen in a while also minimizing risks of COVID-19 exposure?
And that's really the key. You want to minimize risk because there'll never be zero risk. I think the most important things to remember in a situation like this are the three basics. You want to keep in mind that there should be the use of masks, there should be social distancing, and obviously good hygiene. So let's say you're going to the park and you're going to spend some time together. There'll be some food, beverages involved. I think it's important that each group bring their own food and beverages, as well as utensils, plates, whatever's necessary. And then if you're having something at your home where people are coming over, say for a barbecue, I think it's important there to once again maintain the same sort of guidelines. Try to perhaps minimize the number of people you're getting together with. Do it outside as possible. And then if you are serving food, it's important that one person be given a specific job. For example, one person would serve food, someone else would serve some side dishes, someone else would be in charge of distributing condiments. And so, you know, that way you can have a good get together and a safe get together.
And also making sure that we're washing our hands before we're eating, so important. Now, if I take a hike outside with someone who's not in my household, one question a lot of people have to ask, you know, you're exercising, you're outdoors, there's a breeze blowing. So if I'm only hiking with one other person, do I really need to wear a mask at that point in time and stay 6 feet apart from them?
Unfortunately, in the way things are going in today's COVID world, we have to almost assume that everyone could be asymptomatic carrier of coronavirus. So if it's not someone who's in your household and you're going out for a hike, a jog, or even a simple walk, you do need to keep in mind, once again, there needs to be social distancing. You need to be staying that 6 feet apart. You do need to wear a mask. And remember that every time you speak, every time that you are exerting yourself, if you are doing something that involves exercise, you're going to be putting out just so many microscopic droplets. And in those droplets potentially are coronavirus particles. And so I think it's wise to get out, enjoy the outdoors, but once again, do it safely.
Then Dave, one more question for you today. I want to ask, let's say everybody is outside enjoying the nice weather. They're all wearing their masks. If, you know, you have kids at home and they want to go outside and play, is it risky for them to be outside and among other people, even when those folks are wearing masks?
It's interesting because there are no formal guidelines in terms of kids going out and, say, playing in the neighborhood. I think that the best thing a parent can do is to, once again, follow the guidelines that adults do. The masks certainly are important. I think that social distancing should be followed, and certainly good hygiene as well, as we always talk about. I think there needs to be a limitation on the number of kids who are playing together. You also probably need to have some adult supervision involved in there, obviously age dependent. And there also needs to be some sort of a time limit on this, because the longer you are out, the longer the potential for exposure. I think one final thing to think about is to know the people that you're getting together with, as well as who your children are getting together with. It's always important to have similar philosophies about how you feel about prevention of COVID and coronavirus. So it's always good to be on the same page with the people that you're getting together with or your children are getting together with.
Dave, thank you so much for all this valuable information. And hey, for even more tips on summer safety and staying safe outside in gatherings during the COVID-19 pandemic, make sure you head over to cbsdenver.com for all that information. I'm Katie Johnston, covering Colorado First.